Hi there guys, and welcome to another show. This is a show where we talk only about games and gaming industry. Today I'm in Shenzhen and I have awesome opportunity to talk to Donald, the founder of the company APPTUTTi. You're maybe wondering what APPTUTTi is and why I'm so excited. Well, I'm gonna tell you guys, if you are thinking about publishing game in China, your life just got easier. Donald, welcome to our show.
Yeah, thank you. Thank you, Stefan.
So I just want to start and introduce you a little more to our audience. Your background is in IT.
Yeah, actually I'm not quite in, but my IT background is quite long history. But I found the whole industry, the gaming industry in China, that is something require a system, which is IT would be a way to turn around the situation. I myself think the whole industry is not quite structured.
So China is very big, guys. It's the largest gaming in the market in the world. The biggest revenue actually in the gaming industry, especially mobile gaming industry, comes from China. Donald, you worked in Hewlett Packard. You were a director for Asia Pacific in my research.
Yeah, I am an IT guy with a software background. I myself can architect the whole IT system. That is the way we are working for the whole gaming industry in China.
So how long you were working in Hewlett Packard?
5 years.
5 years?
Yeah, I traveled the whole Asia a lot. Major focus would be China, because at that moment, China is also the largest market for the whole Asia.
And when you left Hewlett Packard, what was your next adventure?
I want to do something to my own interest. I design something. I design products. We have been having some very good products, getting very excellent comments on Amazon. But the hardware business is getting tougher because of the low price products flooding around the world. Then we move to software business. Then myself got some relationship with the China mobile people. They are working on their own game store. And they asked me for some international connections for games developer from overseas. I tried to help them. Eventually they got some communication, but eventually they couldn't make out anything. Then I found out there's an issue over there. That's why so limited supplies from overseas to China.
So basically when you left Hewlett Packard, you tried to do something with IoT, right? Here in Shenzhen, which is the world base. This is the base for all hardware products in the world, the biggest place here. And that market was too hard and extremely competitive. So when working with China Mobile, you had a new idea that everybody in China were having a problem onboarding foreign developers. Foreign developers, us today is no different, I think, for you guys when you're looking at China. It was so hard to find a good and suitable support to get to Chinese market. And you recognize this when you were working with China Joy.
Yeah, the problem is not just from the developer end, it's also from the local end. The local market have a very limited supply. And the market, such a world-class market, enjoys just a little amount of the, from the local, and a very, very limited amount from overseas. I believe we can resolve all this problem by an IT platform. That's why we create APPTUTTi.
Yeah. So identifying the need of the market, identify the demand, and knowing that there is a supply overseas.
From China.
So China guys have a huge demand for the foreign made games.
Yes.
The China, actually every Chinese players, they play too many games on their phone. So here it's proven that there is a big need for the overseas developed games. So you had the idea to do APPTUTTi. By my research, it's around 2015.
Yes.
Can you tell me a little more how you started the company?
In the very beginning, I tried to structure, architect the whole thing, the whole process. I researched a lot on the whole process because I personally inside the process when the foreign guys meeting with the China Mobile guy. How they communicate, how they are having misunderstanding with each other, and some technical problem, email communication, personal communication, that is all efficiency issues inside. Then I try to record all users and try to find a way to resolve them by arguing.
So you basically say the language is a problem, culture is a problem, go to market is a problem, marketing itself is a problem.
Yeah.
All these things. And you say
people understanding is also different.
So yeah, the B understanding of your story, correct. So you said, okay, all this aside, I'm going to use IT to solve all these problems.
Yes.
I'm going to engineer the way to find a solution.
Yes, it's true. All these problems because of the human communication, and I think the IT way will be minimizing all this unclear message or misunderstanding message that will be on the IT platform, on the process, on the online process, that will be all clear. If not clear, it will not be going through.
Yeah, exactly. So, you when did you launch the product? When the product went to the market?
Around early 2016. Mm-hmm.
And since then, now we are in mid 2018. How many companies use your? You have SDK product, right?
Yeah.
Okay, it that's all for all China SDK product.
SDK is something that I believe you guys may be knowing that software development kit. This SDK will be converting the foreign game into a China market compatible product, and will be for multi-store. We are covering not just one store. We will be helping them to cover all the major stores in China.
So just to clarify, how many stores in China? We outside of China know only for Google and Apple these days. We only know these two.
Yeah. Well, the peak time in China, I remember 2014, is almost 1,000 stores in China.
1,000 stores in China.
Yeah.
Wow, that's a big number.
Very big
number. You can imagine now, to some of you maybe not understanding how this works, China has no Google, right?
No Google.
And there's no Google Play Store. So every, every carrier or every company can make their own Android store, right?
Yeah, it's true in China. Of course, not all of them are performing well. I think the top 20 would be covering more than 90% of the total users in China.
So from 1,000 stores that we have in China, the 90% of the market is occupied by 20 stores, is that right?
Yeah, but now, after serving consolidation, right now around 200 only.
200?
Yeah.
So today, 2019, we are talking about 200. So how many APPTUTTi has integration with?
We are covering the top 20 already.
Yeah.
We are extending to second tier store as well.
Okay.
Yeah, so maybe up to 30 something.
30 stores. Okay, good. That's a good number, especially because you have top 20 stores in China. Does that include phone manufacturer stores like Huawei store or Oppo store?
Yeah.
Right? Xiaomi, they are also.
Yeah.
All of them.
Mm-hmm. All these are including Tencent, my app store, including those FuseCity, Baidu, and some very local game store.
Mm-hmm.
They are top. They are big, but they are not well known by foreigners.
They're not familiar to people. They maybe don't even have English versions.
They
don't have English. They're just Chinese.
Very local
stores. How heavy is it for somebody to integrate SDK? Is there a big process? How much time on average for a small game?
I can say even the local developers, they spend month time to integrate one by one. So that is a huge job. We try to consolidate all of them into one single SDK. If they are familiar with the integration, a few hours to be done.
In a few hours, it can be finished.
Our own SDK, yeah.
Wow, that's amazing news, guys. Pay good attention now. If you are using APPTUTTi solution for coming to China, there is an SDK that APPTUTTi is providing, and you are able to integrate all Chinese stores. Now we're talking about 20 most that are occupying the most market, and additional 30 is on the way. You're talking about a few hours to get access to entire Chinese market.
If they are familiar with the SDK integration. So the first time maybe take a little bit longer time, the second time, perfect.
So to somebody now who's a developer outside, this sounds too good to be true, right? Instead of being China so far away and not being able to get to the market, now having just a few hours of work and be available. They all maybe used to do traditional method where they find a publisher in China, whether they're looking at maybe NetEase, that is a big publisher, Tencent also, or some, Baidu is also publishing their own games, that they have publishing unit. Let's talk also for you that you know ByteDance is a big publisher. How are you different from this big publisher? What's the key differentiator for APPTUTTi product?
APPTUTTi got a very clear position, is that we are just helping the foreign developers to get their game into China. We that kind of job is also done by Tencent, NetEase, all those big giants. But the way we are different is that they pick the good one only. They just pick the good quality or huge number of games in China. We are an open platform, 24 hours on. We open for any types of games as long as they follow the local regulations that will be helping them. So we can say we are covering 99% of for the foreign developers. Unlike Tencent, that is, they may be just focusing on the top 1% of the world.
So to make this even more clear for you guys, all these big names and big publishers like Tencent and like NetEase and others, they're focusing on the highest end of the games. APPTUTTi is providing a tool for you, a tool for developer, to integrate their game to be compatible with Chinese market. So this is not something that you have to be to apply or something, you just use the tool and follow the rules and regulations. Do you have at this moment on your website maybe a list or a short description of how, what are the rules to educate the foreign developers so they know if their game is suitable or not?
We do have a FAQ on our website on this as well. We do have a partner program policy on our website about this as well. The major point is those pornographics. Not too violent, and no political sensitive thing, and that's all.
Yeah.
So no gambling. Yes.
Yeah, no gambling. Yeah, okay. So the gambling is also the forbidden section. So if you have a gambling game, this is not the right tool for you.
Yeah.
But all other games are welcome. Now, when I was doing the research about APPTUTTi, I was shocked. You have really affordable prices for developers overseas. And some of them are extremely useful. Can you walk me a little bit about the pricing system that you developed? You're giving a freemium solution, so everybody can use to publish the game. And then you're offering additional things. Like I saw that for $200, you can help somebody get an ICP license for their game in China. That's huge. We heard a lot about the licensing problems for the foreign developers and everything. Yeah. You, through your publishing company here, are able to grant everybody in a some foreseeable amount of time, like 45 days for 200 a license, or they have even a speed service, speed service that will help them get in 7 days approved. That's $600. Can you maybe tell me a little bit more how is this possible and what goes with these services?
Yeah, now actually APPTUTTi is more like an incubator for the foreign developers. They can just invest zero, no single penny, then they can get their game as long as they follow the SDK, they integrate the SDK, follow up the rules, then we will be able to help them launch on three stores. It's all free.
Free three stores.
Yeah, three stores. Yeah. And if they want more, we have to apply the license for them. Mm-hmm. It's kind of it's not quite a license, it's a certificate to prove it's the ownership of the game. And then with that certificate we'll be able to launch on five more stores, then we'll be eight. If they really want to cover the whole market. Yeah, there is another package around 4,000, that will be able to get us to help them to apply the ISBN license as well.
Mm-hmm.
It will be taking a little longer time. Then we'll help them to publish on all the top majors, so we'll be up to trend.
Well, that would be like a big VAP service.
Yes.
That's really going to grant them the first.
Our goal is that we also have a program to finance them if they are having financial or resources issues in customizing the game. We are having a program called Honor Financing Program. They can apply that program online. If they prove that they can enter up to 20,000 US as a kind of a funding to help them to customize the game.
So you have a $20,000 grant,
yep,
for everybody who is thinking about coming to China,
yep,
and publishing in China.
A subject to approval.
Yes, subject to approval. Of course, this is a special service that,
yep,
you probably are taking a closer look. There's some application form somewhere.
Yep. Everything online. They can just go to our website and click first. They have to register first,
mm-hmm,
and they have to have a submitted project. Then they will be able to find the page to apply for this.
Okay, we're going to leave in the description, guys, a link to the
yep,
description itself about the grant program that you can enjoy with APPTUTTi and all the requirements and how you get applied for this. I think this is super, super helpful, especially to the indie developers or to the smaller studios that are just starting out. And this is a huge boost and can really give a talented guys a good sense of direction when they are building their game, maybe that need a little support. Now, what I'm particularly interested in is, you mentioned incubation and helping foreign developers. Do you regularly go overseas to events and exhibitions? Do you try to spread the word about how they should build the game, or how should they customize the game to be more suitable for Chinese market?
We will be in China Joy, we will be in Tesla Connect USA, and we will be in Unite Copenhagen. And more to come. I believe the second half of 2019 we will have more chance for sharing and then telling you how we are helping you to get into the largest market over the world.
Well. I'm personally, guys, I learned about APPTUTTi over the last few months, and I think it's a great service, awesome help. We have Donald here, who's really passionate about helping actually foreign developers. His IT background, but his strong engineering is actually what's needed here, because it's going to be super hard for everybody to have on their team a Chinese-speaking employee or a lack of international talent for the corporations here to have the things working. So using IT and having seamless work done without even coming over to China is, I think, in itself an awesome idea for every game developer. Having an additional thing on top of that is giving grants, going overseas to all these big events, and also China Joy is the closest one coming, guys. So if you're coming to China Joy, you can reach out to APPTUTTi. I invite you all to go to Facebook page, like APPTUTTi, Twitter if you guys are running or something like that. Just make sure you get yourself more familiar with APPTUTTi services. Donald, do you have anything to leave our audience with for the end?
Yeah, I want to say I myself a creator. I create products, I create this platform as well. I respect, and we, the whole APPTUTTi team, respect all the creators. Thank you.
Thank you guys for staying with us, and see you in the next show. Stay awesome, take care, and don't forget to follow Game Buzz for all the awesome news in the game industry. Take care, guys.
Thank you.